Pals, it's Miss Lisa, your art teacher. Welcome back to my table of art. Today I want to talk to you. I'm going to give you some of my light. I'm fixing my light. Hold on. Sorry. It's going to fall. It's getting a little dark in here. So I want to make it a little brighter so you can see everything. And I hope that worked. Anyway, today I want to talk to you about symmetry. Symmetrical balance. It's actually like a mirror image. I have a picture of something I want to show you. We have a monarch butterfly. The left side of the monarch butterfly looks the same as the right side of the monarch butterfly. Look at that beautiful monarch. We're going to be making a monarch butterfly today. But on this side, I have a little explanation for you about what symmetry is. Symmetrical balance. Basically a mirror image. One side is the same as the other. Look at the car. One side is the same as the other. Symmetrical balance. Both sides have a center line. Even our face is like symmetrical. And the center line, see that? Both sides are the same. What else could be symmetrical? My shirt. The center line would go down here. The left side would be the same as the right side. How about a pair of pants? The left side would be the same as the right side. How about a book? If I open up the book, the left side is the same as the right side. There's symmetrical balance, symmetry. The monarch butterfly, symmetrical balance, symmetry. So, what we're going to do today is we're going to create a monarch butterfly using a large piece of white paper. So what I want you to do is come on down to my table, have ready some black tempera paint to begin. Then we're going to need some white, yellow, and red tempera paint because the red and the yellow will mix together and create orange. So monarch butterflies are black, white, yellow, and orange. So come on down to my desk and I'll show you how we're going to do this. So you're all going to get the white large piece of paper. And you're going to fold it in half. Now the way we can fold it in half is have one corner meet the other. Hello, corner. Hello, how are you? Other corner meet. So now we have corner to corner. We can bring our fingers to the center, slide down, and across. There we go. I've just folded this sheet of paper. So now, what we need to do, we're going to get our black tempera paint. Now, if you look at your white sheet of paper, put your left hand on one side and your right hand on the other. We are only going to use the right side. We are not going to do anything on the left side. And we're going, here is our center line. And everything's going to be to the right of the center line. Nothing on the left side. So let's start. Here's my center line. I don't know if you can see it because of my light. There's the center line. We're going to start with our paintbrush. And I'm going to dip a little water just to get it started. And we're going to start at almost to the top of our paper. Maybe 3 to 4 fingers down. On the center line, not the left side, we're going to make a little half circle, okay? Just a little half circle. Then we're going to fold our paper in half, and we're going to massage the paper. Massage the paper. Here we go. And then we're going to open it up. Look what we've done. We've created a symmetrical balance between what's on the right and what's on the left. Now let's go back to our black tempera paint and let's make another shape a little bit larger. Then we're going to fold our paper in half. We're going to massage the paper.
massage this paper. And then we're going to open it up again. Look at that. The balance is getting better. Let's dip it back in our paint again. And let's make even one more half circle, a little bit bigger than the second one. Okay. Then what are we going to do? Did you say fold the paper? You're right. Let's fold it in half. And let's massage the paper. Massage the paper. Very, very good. And then what are we going to do? We're going to open up. Look at that. Now, you see there's a little white streak there? Don't worry about this. This is a practice, or you could actually use it as your final, but I don't want anybody stressing over this because this is just fun. Now, let's look at our monarch butterfly. Look how his one wing almost looks like a sideways heart. We're going to try to recreate that on this side here. So I'm going to take my paintbrush again, and I'm going to extend it over a little bit of a heart, and then it's going to come back in. I'm going to add a little bit more paint, go right over that. See how I did that? I'm going right over it again, adding more paint. And you know what we're going to do next? If you said fold the paper in half, you're absolutely right. Ready? Let's fold the paper in half. And now we're going to massage the paper, pressing down and massaging the paper to make sure that we transfer everything that's on the right side of the center line over to the left side of the center line. And we open it up and ooh, it's starting to look pretty darn good, isn't it? Now let's look at our monarch butterfly again. And we have the bottom wing sort of looks just like a slice of watermelon. So let's recreate that using our black paint and our brush. It's going to come down, curve on the bottom, and then come back this way. Okay, I'm going to add more paint because we want to make sure we have enough paint for the other side. Here we go. Let's fold our paper in half again, and we're going to massage the paper. Massage the paper. Good. I think that's good, right? So let's open up our paper. See? Ooh, very nice. This is looking fabuloso. Okay, now, if you look at the butterfly, notice that he has like an edge with white polka dots. So let's create that line for the edge. See, I'm just going to have the edge there, and I'm going to do the bottom one too. A little bit of an edge. What do you think we're going to do again? We're folding the paper and we're going to massage the paper again. And massage the paper again. Then we're going to open her up. Ooh, looking good, looking good. Now we're going to separate these sections with just some lines, black lines. And don't be cheap with the paint. There we go, straight lines. What are we going to do again? You guessed it. Fold it in half and massage the paper again. And massage the paper again. And we're going to open it up. And look at the symmetrical balance. How incredible are we doing? We're doing a great, great job. Now let's look. Notice that the monarch butterfly has all these veins going through their wings. Let's draw those lines next. So we kind of just like haphazardly draw some sectional lines in our butterfly. They don't have to be perfect. They don't have to be accurate. They can be any way you want them to be. Okay? So don't you worry. And we'll do the same for below. Make some of these lines. Now what's next? We're going to fold our paper in half and we're going to massage our paper. And massage our paper. Beautiful, beautiful job. Here we go. go. Let's open it up. Oh my God, how beautiful did that come out? Now, one thing is missing is his little antennas. Now, we only have to draw one because why? Because we're going to close up our paper, massage the paper, and then we're going to open it up again. And what are we going to find? Two antennas on our butterfly. All right, now it's time we add some color. So if you notice, we do have orange, there's some yellow, and we have white. So we're going to take our red, yellow, and white paint. And we're going to start working with that. Let me squeeze it onto my template here, my palette here. Some red and some yellow. We should wait for it to dry. So you guys, you wait for it to dry. I'm doing this because I want to show you the video. Let me get my black paintbrush out of the way. I don't want that to make any mess. What paintbrush shall we use for this painting? I think I shall use this big paintbrush. Dip it in some water here. And I'm not going to touch the edges yet. I'm going to start working. Don't be afraid now to mix your colors. I'm going to just start painting in between the lines. And you're going to do the same. And like I said, you're going to wait for yours to dry. I'm doing this because I'm making a video. There's two parts to this project. Look how I painted right over, and that's okay. I can paint over it as much as I want. And this is the only time that we're not going to, wait, hold on. Let me get this here. Worry about coloring in the lines. I'm gonna add a little bit more yellow because I really want to get more of an orangey look. This is kind of the red is taking over a little bit. So I want to throw in some yellow here. Don't worry about being in the lines. Remember, we're having fun. Now let's put this aside and guess what we're going to do again? Yep, we're going to fold it in half and we're going to massage the paper because we're going to transfer the beautiful yellows and oranges that we just painted onto the both sides of the butterfly. Oh, look at that. It's coming out so beautiful. All right, so now the outside is, remember it was black and white? So we're going to add some white paint to my palette. There we go. Whoopsie. A little dried piece of paint plopped out in there. And I'm going to start filling in these empty areas with some white paint, but I'm mixing a little bit of the red and yellow because I love color and I think monarch butterflies are much prettier with all this extra color. And I'm not being perfect. You notice I'm not being perfect. I'm even making my own little sections. I'm going to go back into my red and maybe add some here. Maybe add some more red here. A little bit of yellow I got left over here. Don't be afraid to paint. Don't be afraid to add color. Okay, time to fold it again. You ready? And we're going to massage all that color in. Massage it all in. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And you ready? Let's open her up. Oh my God, you can't tell me this butterfly is not absolutely gorgeous. That is the most beautiful butterfly. Now, if some of you worry that this has got a line here, feel free to go back with a paintbrush and fill that spot in. I think I'm going to make one last little line going down because I did see a little extra. Oh no, I didn't really. Well, I shouldn't have added that, but that's okay. Let's do our fold and massage it so both sides are the same. His body's really not that long, but I made it that long. He kind of looks like a stinger instead of a butterfly. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to let our butterfly dry. We have a beautifully, symmetrically balanced butterfly. Absolutely beautiful. So let's put him aside so he can dry. I want to show you one that I made earlier. See how pretty that one came out? I made different shape. When it's dry, we're going to cut it out and it'll look similar to this. Why are we cutting it out? And I'm going to show you why. Monarch butterflies only feed on one thing, and it's milkweed. Milkweed has leaves that look kind of like the ones I made, and they range in color anywhere from white to pink. So what we're going to do next, we're going to take another big piece of white construction paper, and we're just going to paint it with watercolor, because we want to do just a light background, sort of so we could see how we have this butterfly here, and you can see the green background. We want to kind of recreate that. He's on a yellow milkweed. They range from pink, yellow, white. We're having a white one for today's project. And the leaves are similar again to this. So we're going to see the light muted green color in the background, which we're going to do with the watercolor. We're going to cut out some green construction paper to create the milkweed leaves. And we're going to put a nice little fluff of cotton to resemble the milkweed itself, the flower. Okay? So the way we're going to do that is we're going to get another piece of construction paper. We're going to pull out our watercolors. We're going to need some water, some clean water, and some clean brushes. Okay, I'm going to make sure this one's clean. This was the black one. Oh, no, that was the black one. Ugh, now it's all dirty. Okay. All right, I'm going to take my watercolors, and I'm going to use a lot of water. And I'm going to put it into my watercolor palettes. I'm going to use yellow and I'm going to use green. So I'm making them very wet. And I'm just going to start randomly painting my white paper. Okay? We just want to go up and down because we're imagining that this is grass, whether it's milkweed or blades of grass that, you know, green grass. But they go in an up and down direction. So we're going to try to stick to that direction as we're painting. We're going to get all the edges, but remember to use a lot of water because we're only using a light background for our butterfly. Okay, see how I'm doing this? I'm just going randomly back and forth and up and down until I cover the whole paper to create our background for our butterfly. So continue doing that. And when this is all done, remember, add the water. Don't be shy with the water. You'll have some dark areas and some light areas, and that'll make it even more beautiful. Okay? So continue doing that till the whole paper is covered, and then it will look like... this. Okay? Then you're going to get the construction paper, green construction paper. I'm going to give you a template to cut out for the leaves. And then I just took a green marker and we're going to make the veins that are inside the leaves. Light green, dark green, whatever kind of green, just so it shows up so you can see the leaves' veins. What I did was I folded them so that I could glue the base to the paper. I put a little fold at the bottom of the leaf so that they came out like a little three-dimensional. This one I folded up, and this one I just curled a little bit to the side. So when my butterfly dries, which I already have a dry butterfly, where did I put that butterfly? I think that butterfly flew away. Butterfly, butterfly, come back wherever you are. All right, here's the wet one. This is the one we just made. What did I just do with that other butterfly? Okay, this leaf is cracking up. I lost the butterfly. This is drying. I really did. The butterfly is missing. Okay, well, when your butterfly is dry, you're going to cut around the butterfly. Watch how I do. You don't have to cut on the butterfly. We just want to get the idea of the shape of the butterfly. It does not have to be perfect. So I'm going to cut around my butterfly, which is still wet, but the fact that I can't find the other butterfly I just showed you, I mean, this is not a big room. I don't know where it went. I think it actually flew away. Does anybody see my butterfly behind me? Around me? Where did it go? This is cuckoo. Cuckoo! Cuckoo! Where's my butterfly? Okay. So you're all going to get two of these large sheets of white paper. One for the butterfly and one for the milkweed and the background, okay? Because we're going to take our two-dimensional symmetrical butterfly and we want to make it somewhat of a three-dimensional picture, okay? Now with the antennas, you do not have to cut out the antennas. You can go around the antennas. Watch what I do. Around the V, around, and then the V, around again. Up and down and around. You know, if you're coming in this summer, I hear I might be coming back in person. That would be so nice. I get to see all your beautiful faces again and great smiles. I miss your great smiles. And we could do art together and have fun. There we go. Okay, so once my butterfly is cut out, then I would place him on my background, but I don't want to place him so he fits. I want him to come off the edge of the paper. Okay, it gives it a better look, more of a three-dimensional look. And we are done. What do you think, guys? Do you like your butterflies? Do you like your monarchs? Let me bring this up so I can see you. Oh, there's my helping hand. I'm going to hold this up. Look at that. That is so beautiful. Symmetrical butterfly, monarch butterfly, feeding off of the milkweed, which is all they eat. They don't eat anything else. And you know what happens? I actually have a friend that breeds the monarch butterflies, and she marks them once they metamorphose into their butterfly, from the caterpillar to the butterfly. She tags all of her butterflies, and they fly to Mexico, the same place every year. How they know how to get there, I have no idea. She has no idea. They go down to the warm weather, and they stay there. And people that find them record the markings, and there's a whole network of all these people that raise butterflies and set them free, and they get recordings from people that have found them, have spotted them along their route to Mexico. It's amazing. And she taught me all about the butterfly, that they only eat this milkweed. And look at this. This is a beautiful project. I hope you guys enjoy doing this because I really love doing it myself. So today we learned a little bit about symmetry, symmetrical balance, a little bit about the monarch butterfly, milkweed. We did a little watercolor. We had a little fun. I hope we had fun. I wish I had a song I could sing for you, but I don't have a song today. So maybe next time I'll come back with a song, okay? So until then, guys, you have a great day. Have a great week. Stay well. I hope to see you soon. I have a feeling it is coming, so hang in there. And we can do art together. Yay! What better thing than that? So this is Miss Lisa, your art teacher, saying ciao for now from my table of art. Bye, guys.